Thank you. What happened to you guys?
You should see the other guy.
Thank you.
Thank you. them.
Thank you.
that's okay.
Thank you.
duties set forth and made known in the following proclamation. Let all our subjects strive to live in peace, charity, and goodwill one towards the other. Let the love of truth be cherished. Let the respectful and ready obedience be given to all parents, teachers, and those placed in authority. Let all animals in all places in our dominion shall be kindly treated. Let no birds shall be maimed, and that none of their nests shall be molested. But lastly, all our faithful and devoted subjects appear before us each year at our Lanimer Festival, and that any person found guilty of disobeying these provisions shall incur our royal displeasure. Given at our court at Lanimer this 11th day of June, in the year of our Lord, 1981, Jacqueline the First, Lanimer Queen. 3 cheers for the Lanimer Queen. Hip, hip.
And this year, I went along to see how the celebrations fit into the life of a country town in the 1980s. But first, Let's see how things looked a few decades ago.
Historic film of Lanark's Lanimer Celebrations. It was shot back in the early 50s when all summer long the sun used to shine, the sky was blue, the weather was hot. But it's not like that anymore. June the 11th, this year's Lanimer Day, started cold, windy and wet. And that's how it stayed for most of the day. Nonetheless, the crowds turned out in their thousands for the famous Lanimer Day procession, the highlight of a week's celebrations which have their roots centuries back in medieval history. Lanark was proclaimed a royal borough in the mid-12th century by David I, and every year since there's been a Lanimer procession. It started as a perambulation of the borough boundaries to make sure that none of the neighbouring landowners had encroached on the Lanark territories. The bounds are still ridden, but the perambulation has also developed into today's great procession of floats, tableaus, pageants, marches and music, all lovingly prepared by local groups, schools, parents and, of course, the children. About 1,000 of them, in a procession which has taken literally months to get ready.
These preparations start in October of the previous year, usually, with our annual general meeting when the committee elects its office bearers, and then everything then swings into action. Independent from the committee, you remember that I'm the secretary of the Lanimer committee, but that is a formal part of it. But behind the scenes, the parents meanwhile are planning on their own the actual floats, the tableaus that they intend to put in for the Lanimer procession the following year. And this starts a very early date. Sometime we have streets who do it collectively, and in some cases the schools who make up a theme early in the year and prepare at a very early date for Lanimer Week.
Well, you're talking about it in a modern sense. What about the traditions that lie behind Lanimer Week?
Well, these, of course, go back to the foundation of the borough itself, the granting of the Royal Charter, which is around 1140. We say quite definitely 1140, which we say is the oldest royal borough in Scotland. The tradition behind that, the tradition of Lanimer Week, the name Lanimers, I think by common consent, is said to be a corruption of the land marches, the inspection of the borough boundaries, and this must have been going on for the last 800 odd years. On the Monday of Lanimer Week, the town, probably 2,000 people, get together and they perambulate the marches, which is the walking of the marches, the inspection of the boundaries, and they proceed around these old march stones. There are only a few left now, but they're very jealously maintained, and these are inspected on the Monday of Lanimer Week by the whole townspeople. Thereafter, they come down the main street of the town, the Lord Cornets, that is the borough standard bearer of the year, and the ex-borough standard bearers, such as myself, wearing the sash, they are mounted and come down the high street at the end of the inspection of the boundary. You have perhaps noticed in the town branches of trees, and that is branches of birks, and that goes back to some probably 200 years ago, when there was some opposition put up by the Laird of Jerviswood about inspecting boundaries, since it meant crossing his ground, and he tried to prevent the inspection of the borough boundaries, and in this he was supported at the time by the magistrates, but a group of citizens got together and marched through his ground, and in so doing pulled off branches of twigs and brought them back, although I think they brought back larger branches that we bring now. We just bring little sprigs, and that indicates that the borough boundaries have been inspected, and the in evidence of this, they carry them down the main street, high street of Lanark.
Everyone in the procession was up and about long before most of us had even begun to think about waking. Lanimer Queen, Lord Cornet and Lanimer Court were fully dressed in their ceremonial garb, trapped and accoutred and away from home by 8:15, while the other attendants were at the stables well before 8. Indeed, things began so early that by 9:30 everyone who was free felt able to take a generous stirrup cup, not to mention some light alcoholic refreshment at a reception given in the district council offices. Thus fortified, the procession was ready to set off, led, as always, by the Lord Cornet. This year, the role fell to Dr. Stephen Telfer, a local GP. He's very well aware that being Lord Cornet means a great deal more than just being able to sit on a horse and carry a flag.
There are several duties. That's the main one today, obviously. And we actually call it the standard rather than a flag because we're very touchy about it. Basically, the office of Lord Cornet involves being a representative of the people in the town for a year and going round other festivals in the borders largely and in the East Coast and representing the town of Lanark at these festivals. And their representatives come here and join with us on Lanimer Day. And basically, that's the modern job of a Lord Cornet. He has other functions in that he goes around opening various things and making the prize givings at various things, visiting the schools to keep them in the picture. But basically, that's the sort of thing that we do.
When you were chosen as Lord Cornet and when you were riding in the procession, all this sort of thing, how conscious are you of the traditions behind the office?
Oh, I think you're very conscious of it. It's in the town of Lanark, it's sort of every young man's dream, really, to become this. And Lanark's a town in which the people are very, very aware of their tradition, you know. Wallace looks over us every day, and I think you could probably stop the next 100 people in Lanark who were Lanarkians. 99 of them would know a vast amount about the history of Lanark. Maybe not very deeply, but they would know roughly what had happened here in the past. And I think that's one of the strong points of the town of Lanark, actually. And I think that's why our Lanimers are such a great success, you know. You can turn out the whole town every year because we are really, this is a modern manifestation of tradition, really.
Well, the whole town turning out, as you say. How much are you aware of the public eye being on you when you're riding in the procession? How nervous are you?
Well, you're totally aware of the public eye, and I think you're a bit apprehensive before it starts. I think you're apprehensive in case you make a gaffe. But I think once it starts and, the people are cheering and the bands are going and the children are in the procession, there's far too much to take up your attention to be nervous. At least that was my experience.
And as the procession wound on through the streets of Lanark, the rain continued to pour. Such was the infectious enthusiasm and the festive spirit of the Lanimers, nobody seemed to mind very much, even though it was the worst Lanimer Day weather in at least 65 years. And that's an authoritative figure. Jim Barry, who was Lord Cornet in 1943, first rode in the Lanimers in 1914.
There have been odd days that's been wet, but nothing compared to this. But the worst day that I got was away back in the... I would say it would be about 1916, thunder and lightning. And it nearly killed the Lanimers altogether then.
How bad was the thunder and lightning?
Well, it was so bad that one of the lightning struck the church in Hope Street and went right down the steeple and in below the ground.
What is the difference between Lanimer Day now and, say, in 1914, 1916?
Well, in 1914, the only... road on the Monday. They shifted the standard on the Monday night, and then there were nothing till the Thursday for the Lanimer morning. And there were one policeman rode during the Lanimer Day, and now there were all the police horses. They started after the last war finished. They got police horses from Glasgow. But when I was Cornet, and up till then, I had to find my own horse. And of course, you went round the district, you see, and get one here and there, maybe a different one every year, just to take what you could get. I've ridden every year since after the war. Missed about 2 years, I think, of the first war. I've ridden every year since.
So Lanimer's has obviously changed vastly, even within living memory. There are those who say that the town of Lanark is losing its old identity, that ancient traditions are being lost, but even Lanimer Day itself has changed beyond recognition from its ancient origins. I put it to Henry Shanks of the Lanimer Committee that perhaps the Lanimers had become debased.
No, I think it's an improvement, really. As it was originally, simply the inspection of the boundaries, I suppose legally all that was intended by an inspection of the marked stones was to make sure that the adjoining landowners didn't pinch a piece of ground. But now we have made this a real community effort, And although in common with the small boroughs throughout Scotland, we have lost by not having a town council now, so therefore we are part of a larger district and we get a great deal of support from the district authority, but it's up to each community throughout the district to maintain its identity. And this, to my mind, is a great means of doing this. Lanimer Celebrations, we have on Lanimer Day itself on the Thursday, all of the town closing down and all going on holiday and participating in the Lanimer Procession. And this gives them a great sense of identity, not only those of us who are born and brought up and call ourselves Lanarkians, but also those of the newcomers, people who have just recently arrived in the town. Soon they are participating in the Lanimer event and feel part of the town of Lanark. And I think this is a better thing simply than the mechanical inspection of boundaries.
After the procession, the coronation of the Lanimer Queen, 12-year-old Jacqueline Loughery, Queen Jacqueline I, whose first royal deed was the Lanimer Proclamation read by the First Lord of her court. It exhorts all her subjects to strive for peace, charity and goodwill, to love truth, to be respectful and obedient to parents, teachers, and all those in authority, to be kind to animals and birds, and lastly, to appear faithfully before the Lanimer Queen at each Lanimer festival. Any person guilty of disobeying to incur Her Majesty's royal displeasure. And later still, the races. If prizes are the main incentive to win, then surely the fiercest competition must be for the Lord Cornet's bottle of brandy. But there's also a 5-furlong chase for the Cornets, the race for the Borough Spurs, a whole host of events to delight the horsey contingent from this centre of country life. But it's not just at the racetrack that Lanarkians are celebrating Lanimers. The fun fair is another medieval tradition, though in its modern form it may not look much like a celebration dating back to the Middle Ages. But it too is a permanent Lanimer fixture now, even if many of the fun seekers don't care much about its traditions. Here and throughout the town, the Lanimer spirit, both in the soul and in the glass, will linger for some considerable time. No wonder it's been written of the Lanimers that this week should carry a government health warning. Anyone here will tell you that Lanark is the greatest wee town in the world. Lanimer Day is their way of telling each other just that. And if the rest of the world doesn't get the message, well, that's the rest of the world's tough luck. But at least everyone's had enormous fun trying to get it across. As for the main participants, the children, well, there's no doubt about their feelings. Next year's Lanimers just can't come soon enough. Well, it was a wonderful day despite the weather, and may we just thank everybody connected with Lanimer Day for their help in making that film, as well as Ronald Singleton and the Scottish Film Archive for the archive pictures. The headlines.
Most people back the government...